Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain you Dolph Tchebyshev Array. So in this antenna array, direction of beam of radiation is swept or scanned by changing frequency. So by using Dolph Tchebyshev antenna array, we can change the direction of antenna beam by changing frequency. So I'll explain how we can change direction of antenna by changing frequency later. First of all, let us try to understand those basics which is there with Dolph Tchebyshev array. So basic agenda of Dolph Tchebyshev array is to change direction of beam by changing frequency. So consider a line fed array uniformly spaced element with a receiver or a transmitter connected to the right end of the line as shown in figure. So here we have transmitter, we can have a receiver even, that is connected with these elements where these are dipoles. By this sky blue color, here dipoles are there. So dipole antenna, that is there. Here by this greenish color, we have directional coupler. So this is directional coupler and these are match termination. So these are matched termination. And here we have a transmitter. Now, if I say I have certain amount of frequency, so that will leads to certain amount of wavelength. So at certain frequency, if I say this array of antenna that is radiating in this direction, and that radiation that is happening at angle phi, then how could I change the direction of radiation? So this is what the case which is happening, let us say phi 1 angle at wavelength lambda 1. Then at other wavelength we can steer this beam. Like see, for example, right now beam is in this direction. And this angle is phi 2. And that is happening at angle, wavelength lambda 2. So by changing wavelength, means by changing frequency, we can change this beam. So how to do this? Let us try to understand that. So here pattern, position of antenna and coupler is fixed and direction of radiation can be changed by changing frequency. Here angle of radiation that is expressed as phi. So we can say angle of radiation as per Dolph Tchebyshev array that could be explained by cos of phi, that is equals to C by V plus M divided by D divided by lambda, where C is velocity of light, V is phase velocity, M is mode number, D is spacing between elements, lambda is wavelength. So for this particular case of array, this radiation of phase that is happening at phi and cos phi is equals to c by v plus m divided by d by lambda. So this formula will be helping you to understand how angle of beam that could be steer. So let us consider one example so it will be more clear. So if I consider c is equals to v, lambda is equals to d, and m is equals to minus 1. So for this case, if I substitute those values in this formula, then cos phi, that will be 1 plus m is equals to minus 1 divided by, this will be 1. So 1 minus 1, so that will be 0. So cos phi is equals to 0 means phi is equals to 90 degree. Now let us consider second case. Now if I say for second case c is equals to v, lambda is equals to 0.9 d and m is equals to minus 1. So mode number is equals to minus 1 in this case. So in that case, cos phi is equals to c by v, that is 1, plus m is equals to minus 1 divided by d by lambda. So d by lambda, that is 1 divided by 0.9. So ultimately this will be cos phi is equals to 1, this will go up, so it will be minus 0.9. So cos phi, that is 0.1. So phi is equals to cos inverse 0.1. So cos inverse 0.1, that is 84.26. So one can observe here I have changed my wavelength. So by changing wavelength I can change frequency. So ultimately I have changed frequency, and by changing frequency I have changed wavelength. So if I change frequency, beam direction that have changed. Now it is 84.26. In previous case, in case of lambda is equals to d, that phi was 90 degree. Now for lambda is equals to 0.9 d, that phi is 84.26. So this is how we can steer beam by changing frequency. So in Dolph Tchebyshev array, we can steer antenna beam by changing frequency. So this is very important formula. Cos phi is equals to c by v plus m by d divided by lambda. So by using this formula, one can calculate how we can steer a beam of antenna array. So this method of Dolph Tchebyshev array, that is very important. It has these advantages. It has no moving part. Everything is fixed. No phase shifter is required in antenna circuit. There is no switches required. It is simplest type of scanned array. The reason is, here we don't move anything. We can scan beam without having a movement of antenna. We don't physically move antenna. Antenna's beam, that is getting steered by changing frequency. So all we need to do is, we need to change frequency, automatically beam will get steer. So that is so essential and it is so innovative. So ultimately this Dolph Tchebyshev array is very helpful to scan beam by changing frequency. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any suggestions regarding this video, you can place it in suggestions. Definitely I'll get back to you based on your suggestions. You can suggest me those videos even which is required to complete antenna and wave propagation playlist. If I have a knowledge about those topics, definitely I'll help you out for that. Recently I have made my website. You can go through my website. description of website, link of website that is there in description of this video. So you just go through description of this video in YouTube, you'll be finding my website from where you can download all those materials which I am explaining here on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching this video.